If you're a beginner and you are dreaming about the planche, there is an exercise that I highly recommend to learn before you start training for the planche. And this exercise is the elbow lever. We can say that the elbow lever is the planche of the beginners. For the first sight, many outsiders can't even distinguish the planche and the elbow lever. They look similar, but there is a huge difference between them. In the elbow lever, your whole body supports on your elbows, meanwhile, in the planche, your elbows are locked away from your body. Maybe as an outsider, it's not a huge difference, because hey, the whole body is horizontal, it looks dope, but believe me, the straight arm is a huge difference. Ask someone who trains for the planche and suffers with the straight arm strength. It's brutal and gets even harder and harder as you progress. Yes, the planche is really difficult, an advanced exercise, and that's why I think you have to do everything that can help your progress, make it easier and smoother as much as possible. In my opinion, the elbow lever is a really underrated exercise. It teaches you a lot that you'll benefit in the planche, and what exactly are these will be revealed in this video. What's up guys, it's Adam from gymnasticsmethod.com. If you don't want to miss my videos about bodyweight training and lifestyle, please subscribe and click on the bell. Thank you. And if you want to get access to all the Gymnastics Method workout programs, tutorials like planche, handstand or muscle up, nutrition guide, daily workouts and much more, click the link below and become a member now on gymnasticsmethod.com. So, elbow lever. The elbow lever is a static beginner exercise where you need to hold your whole body horizontally, supporting on your hands with bent arms. For this exercise, of course you need joint preparation and basic strength, but besides these, you need balance as well. If you have a basic upper body strength that allows you to hold the position, the only skill you need is the balance and patient practice. You can do the elbow lever on parallettes, on the ground, or on the rings. In my opinion, this is the right order in terms of difficulty. This is a relatively easy exercise, but as I mentioned, it helps a lot for the planche. You will experience to hold your entire body and legs up horizontally for the first time, just like in the planche. However, you will feel its transfer effect in other exercises as well. In my opinion, one of the most important benefits that the elbow lever teaches you and you can implement in your planche training is the rounded back position. The depressed and abducted scapula position and the rounded back are crucial in the planche. And the best thing is that the elbow lever teaches you this move without you even noticing it. And this is because you really need to do this for only getting the starting position. In the elbow lever, you need to support with your elbows on your hip bones to be able to hold the right position. To do this, you really need to round your upper back. This is really important because you may haven't noticed it, but when athletes do planche, they pay attention to the rounded back with the right scapula position and tight core. Sometimes it's not that spectacular because some athletes do it with extra rounded back, some don't, but the point is that you need to focus on that when you're doing the planche, even if it's not that spectacular. In the elbow lever, it's automatic, since if you don't do it, your elbows slip to the side and it's going to be much harder to hold the position. I'm going to talk about the right technique and progressions, but before that, let's check what are the prerequisites of the elbow lever. As I always say when we are talking about exercises in support, like push-ups, dips, handstand, etc., when some of your joints are under continuous load, so in the elbow lever, I recommend to prepare your wrists, elbows, scapulas, shoulders, and core. I have mentioned the importance of joint preparation in many of my previous videos, so if you follow the channel for a while, you probably know it. My students and I always do a general warm-up and prehab routine before every workout to move around the whole body, oil the joints, ensure the maximal endurance, and decrease the risk of injuries. I made videos about all the areas I mentioned, the wrists, elbows, scapulas, shoulders, and core, so if you're interested, check out the prehab series on the channel. Subscribe for more, and if you're interested in a complex system, a well-structured joint preparation program, click the link below and join now on gymnasticsmethod.com. Besides the joint preparation, the other prerequisite of the elbow lever is a basic pushing strength, which you can build up with push-ups. I made a whole video about how to do push-ups that you can check out on the channel. If you can do the push-ups with the right implementation and reps I mentioned in that video, you will have a much easier deal with the elbow lever, or you can improve both at the same time. Let's see the key points of the elbow lever. If you're doing the elbow lever on the ground, start from kneeling. If you're doing on parallettes, then start from squat. If you're doing it on the rings, you can lower the rings at the same height as the parallettes, or you can start in straight arm support. Place your hands narrower than shoulder width with outward looking fingers on the ground. Do the same narrow distance with the parallettes. On the rings, turn out the rings to be in line in front of your body. Depress and abduct your scapulas, round your back and do posterior pelvic tilt with tight abs and glutes. Place your elbows to your hip bones or the inner side of them. From here, lean to your hands while you're extending and closing your legs. If you do this on an elevated surface or on the rings, this movement is going to be a simple forward lean with straight body. Try to hold the balance with your hands. Your elbows need to be approximately in 120 degrees while you are holding your body straight and tight. Breathe normally through your nose during the exercise, don't hold your breath. This is the right implementation. Before we get into the progressions, you need to understand the following. The elbow lever is like a seesaw. You need to support on your hands while your body is supported on your elbows, and you need to keep the fulcrum in the middle depending on how you hold your legs. If you draw a line upwards from your hands and we consider the upper body and lower body as two leverages, you have to keep the balance between those two leverages. Since the length of your upper body is fixed, but you can play with the length of your legs, you need to adjust your elbow angle according to your leg position. The angle of the elbow flexion will be different in a tuck elbow lever than in a full elbow lever. This is how you need to adjust it. And now, let's see the progressions, how you can build up the elbow lever. If you're a beginner, start to practice on medium-sized parallettes, because there you can get access to the right position more easily and you have more room for your legs. If you don't have parallettes, you can practice it on a higher surface like a table, bench or whatever. Before you start practicing the elbow lever, I suggest to try the right arm position. You can do this in standing or kneeling. Depress and abduct your scapulas, round your back and do posterior pelvic tilt with tight abs and glutes. Place your elbows to your hip bones or the inner side of them. Bend your elbows in 90 degrees. This is the right arm position. In the next progression, you need to implement the right arm position you learned before. Start from squat, keep the parallettes narrow. This is how you can get into the right position more easily. From the squat, you can get into the right position even with keeping your legs on the ground. If you feel this position stable, you can elevate your legs controlled and try to hold the balance. Here, you need to hold your elbows in 90 degrees. Do 10 reps 3 times. The goal is to feel the balance so you can hold the tuck elbow lever. In the tuck elbow lever, you need to pay attention to the previous key points, but now the goal is to do a longer hold with keeping the balance. Start from squat, keep the parallettes narrow. This is how you can get into the right position more easily. If you got into the right position, elevate your legs, keep them bent and hold the tuck elbow lever. Do 30 seconds hold 3 times and step to the next progression. In this progression, we unfold the body even more, and as I mentioned, we extend the elbows a little more. Do everything the same way as you did in the previous progression. In the tuck elbow lever, your elbows need to be 90 degrees, and as you extend your legs into the straddle, you need to slightly extend your elbows. If you don't extend your arms and you just extend your legs, you will fall down to the leg side. And when you're doing the straddle elbow lever, you may feel cramping in your hip abductors and glutes. This is totally normal. Don't be surprised if you have never used your muscles like this before. It's good to get used to this in the planche perspective as well. Do 20 seconds hold 3 times. In the straddle elbow lever, many people feel the balance and how to play with the elbow extension, so they learn the full elbow lever easily. If you can do the straddle elbow lever with confidence, you just need to close your legs controlled and extend your elbows a little more. Pay attention to the key points and you'll be able to do it in no time. A common mistake is the wrong positioning of the arms and the elbows slip to the side. Yes, I know it's an uncomfortable position and it can irritate your skin, etc., but if you know how to do it right, it makes the whole exercise a lot easier. By the way, there is nothing wrong if you want to hold your elbows next to your body, but it's a different exercise. That's the bent arm lever. You need more pushing strength for this, but it's not impossible. So keep that in mind if you want to set new goals or you want to try something more difficult. The bent arm lever is an option as well. That's a perfect prerequisite of the planche as well. It's harder than the elbow lever, but easier than the planche, so it's in between those two. Another mistake is to do the exercise in a rush. Since we are talking about an exercise where you need to concentrate and hold your entire body in balance, it's not gonna work in the rush. You need to work with slow and controlled movements and focus on the balance. As I have already mentioned, if you just extend your legs and keep your arms in 90 degrees, you will fall. There will be no balance. But if you pay attention to the key points I told you and you do these progressions, you will succeed. So, this would be the elbow lever, a static exercise I highly recommend to learn if the planche is on your list or if you just simply want to learn a dope exercise. You need to practice this exercise a lot, but not nearly as much as the planche. However, it's really spectacular, useful, I have already mentioned its transfer effects, so in my opinion, it's a no-brainer to learn it. If you're interested in the complete, proven to work gymnastics method system, you want to learn all the most effective and iconic gymnastics and calisthenics exercises with the proper sets and reps, you want to learn the planche step by step, or you want to get the shredded physique of a gymnast, click the link below and join now on gymnasticsmethod.com. Thank you so much for watching, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did so, please like, share and write a comment what do you want to see in the next videos. If you don't want to miss the new videos, subscribe with notifications on and see you next week in the next video.